More and more children are out of school, but parents don't want math learning to stop. They're turning to Mathnasium at home. Real-time math instruction tailored to your child's exact educational needs. It's the same face-to-face live instruction used in our centers for over 15 years, now on a computer. Your child can keep their math skills sharp, catch up, or soar ahead, from home or anywhere with an internet connection. To learn if Mathnasium at home is right for your child, visit mathnasium.com/at home. Mathnasium at home, changing lives through math.
Good day, and welcome to the Mathnasium Schoolhouse. My name is Larry. Today we're going to turn our attention to divisibility rules, those almost magical rules that allow us to know when one number divides into another number without actually having to do the slide on the screen. And there's an analogy here. The word Nick is made up of four letters, N-I-C-K, just as the number 3690 is made up of four digits, 3, 6, 9, and 0. So words are made up of letters, and numbers are made up of digits. It's also worth noting that two of the letters, A and I, are also words, as in, I think it's a good idea that people study math, and a good idea that I, so we know that A and I are words. And it also turns out all 10 of the digits, 0 through 9, are both digits and they are numbers. So the topic, as I said today, is divisibility. And the key thing about the word divisibility is that, as I said earlier, it implies that one number goes into another number evenly, that is, with no remainder. One really good example of divisibility that most students learn pretty early, actually in lower elementary, is, without calling it the divisibility rule for 2, they learn that even numbers can be divided evenly by 2, so every even number is divisible by 2, whereas odd numbers, every time you divide an odd number by 2, it doesn't come out even. What you always get is remainder 1. So odd numbers are not divisible by 2. So the divisibility rule for 2 is pretty straightforward. A number is divisible by 2 if the number has an even digit in the ones place. So take a look at these two examples on the screen here. 318 is divisible by 2 because there is indeed an even digit in the ones place. Whereas 283 is not divisible by 2 because there is that odd digit there, and odd digits are not divisible by 2, so 283 is not divisible by 2. So take a look now at the numbers down below, and tell me, which of those are divisible by 2? I think a good way to respond here would be yes, no. So 3,150, is that divisible by 2, yes or no? Yeah, it takes a second for the chat box to catch up here. Good, you all recognize that 0 is indeed an even digit, and it's in the ones place, so 3,150 is indeed divisible by 2. 431, on the other hand, has an odd digit, so that's not going to qualify. Now, some of you are giving me, let's go through them one by one. 134, even digit in the ones place, that's even, so that's divisible by 2. And finally, 369, nope. Got an odd digit there in the ones place. We talked about the ones place. Sometimes we also just say, kind of informally, if there is an even digit, if the last digit is even. And that idea of last digit is going to play in as we look at some more of the divisibility rules. So we've got a rule for 2 now. If the last digit, the digit in the ones place, is even, number is divisible by 2. What about for a number to be divisible by 4? Well, let's see. Divisibility rule for 4 is kind of similar to the rule for 2, except this time, instead of looking at the last digit, we look at the last 2 digits. So in the examples here at the bullet points, 1,548 is indeed divisible by 4 because 48 is divisible by 4. I trust you all know your times tables. 12 times 4 is 48. So 1548 is divisible by 4, whereas 214, we don't care about the 200, but we do care about those last 2 digits, the 14, which is not divisible by 4, so the entire number 214 is not. So again, hey, let's take a look at these numbers now. Which of these now is going to be divisible by 4? Well, we saw a moment ago that in 48, and we're only concerned about the last 2 digits, so it doesn't matter what comes in front. For the divisibility rule for 4, we're looking at the last 2 digits. So 348 is divisible by 4. How about 7,136? And I see that's in most people's list there. Excellent. 431. Well, can't be divisible by 4 because it's not even divisible by 2. So that's not going to work. And similarly for 369, that odd digit in the ones place means that we're not going to be able to get off the ground with this divisibility rule for 369 either. An interesting way to think about divisibility by 4, the numbers I've had up here so far have been pretty straightforward, but let's say you weren't sure whether 48 was divisible by 4, either here or in the example down below. A really cool way to divide a number by 4 is to cut it in half 2 times. Because if you cut something in half, you got 2 pieces, you got each of those 2 pieces in half, you got 4 pieces. So the fast way to divide by 4 is to cut something in half twice. So half of 48 is 24, half of 24 is 12. So yes, indeed, 48 is divisible by 4. And that strategy right there of thinking of half of a half plays very nicely as we move on to the next divisibility rule here, which is the divisibility rule for 8. Now, there's a couple of ways to handle this. Well, first of all, let's see what the basic rule is. A number is divisible by 8 if the last 3 digits of the number are divisible by 8. So the rule for 2 was the last digit, the rule for 4 was the last 2 digits, and the rule for 8 is the last 3 digits. So let's check this out. Now, 240 is, are the last 3 digits of 3,240, so is that divisible by 8? Well, we look at it, 24 is divisible by 8, 0 is divisible by 8, so that's one way we can know that indeed 280 is divisible by 8 in this case. We can also extend the strategy that we used for divisibility by 4 to, instead of half of a half, we can do it, instead of twice, we can do it 3 times. So if we take half of a half of a half of a number, we get the same answer as if we divide by 8. So let's do that. So 240 divided by 2 is, 120. 120 divided by 8 is, 1260. And 60 divided by 2 is 30. So we could do it 3 times. So indeed, 240 is divisible by 8. If we look at 110, yeah, you might not be sure if 8 goes into 110, but so let's use the halving method now. Half of 110, well, half of 100 is 50. Half of 10 is 5. So put those together, we get 55. Whoop, half of 55, there's an odd digit there in the ones place, so it's not going to work. So 110 is not divisible by 8, because if it was, we'd be able to cut it in half 3 times and get whole numbers every time. So I see people are already jumping ahead into the questions down below. Nice job. Let's see which of these are divisible by 8. Well, indeed, 32,280. And let's do 280, and using the half of a half of a half method. So half of 280 is 140, 140. Half of 140, half of 14 is 7, so it's 70. And half of 70 is 35. So yes, everyone that has 32, 280 is absolutely correct. Similarly, 17,248, let's see, 248. Can that be divided by 8? Well, 24 divided by 8 is 3, and 8 divided by 8 is 1, so yes, it goes. If you're not sure, let's use that half of a half method. That's pretty straightforward. See, half of 248 is 124, and half of 124 is 62. Can we go again? Yeah, we can. Half of 62 is 31. So this is, among other things, is very, very good mental math practice. Let's take a look now at the third number here, pretty big numbers, 651,349. And all we're concerned about are those last 3 digits. Well, immediately looking at that, 349, we can't divide that by 2, so 8 is, we're not going to be able to divide it once, so definitely cannot do it 3 times. So 651,349 is not divisible by 8. And I think the last one there is pretty transparent. We're looking at the last 3 digits, 880. That can definitely be divided by 8 if you do it quickly as a short division problem. Or, again, the half of a half of a half technique, once you're good at it, is a great tool for quickly doing these kind of calculations. So half of 880 is 440, half of that is 220, and half of that is 110. So indeed, we can cut it in half 3 times, which means that 23,880 is also divisible by 8. So let's quickly recap here. For divisibility rule for 2, we saw is if the last digit is divisible by 2, the number is divisible by 2. If the last 2 digits are divisible by 4, the number is divisible by 4. And finally, if the last three digits are divisible by 8, the number is divisible by 8. So that's our first kind of grouping of divisibility rules. And I grouped them that way because I found over the years teaching students that it makes it pretty convenient to remember those strategies. So let's go back to our rules here. Next rule is something, again, most students pick up with, either formally or informally in elementary school, and that is the divisibility rule for 5. When I work with elementary kids on this, I'll ask them to, hey, count by 5s for me. Start at 0. 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. And looking at that last digit, whenever we count by 5s, the last digit is either a 0 or a 5. So the divisibility rule for 5, very straightforwardly, is numbers divisible by 5 if the ones digit, that is, if the last digit, is either a 0 or a 5. So taking a look at the examples here, again, this time we're looking at the very last digit, and in the first two examples, one is a 5 and one is a 0, so each one of those is divisible by 5. Whereas 248 is not divisible by 5, it ends in an 8, not a 0 or a 5, so that's not a 5's number. And looking down below, I think it's fairly quick to say that the first 2008-03 is not divisible by 5. 1005 definitely is. It ends with a 5, as does 435. And finally, 199 definitely not. There's a 9 there. We're looking for a 0 or a 5. Now, closely related to the rule for 5 is the rule for 10. And a number is divisible by 10 if the ones digit is a 0. Again, when working with the younger kids, they start to get an informal feel of this when you ask them to count by 10s, and they go 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and sometimes they don't notice, so it's worthwhile for a parent or a teacher to point out that when you're counting by 10s, the ones digit, is always a 0. And that gives us our divisibility rule for 10, which is that if the ones digit is indeed 0, boom, the number is divisible by 10, no questions asked. Now, it's interesting, some numbers can be divisible by 5, but not by 10. Let's go back one slide here. Take a look at the second number down below, the 1005. The rule for 5 and 10 is similar, except for 5, we need that to end with a 5. So a number can be divisible by 5, but not by 10. Whereas, again, looking at the rule for 10, let's take the 2004-20 number there. That is divisible by 10, certainly, because it ends in a 0, but it's also divisible by 5. So it's important to keep in mind that sometimes rules work one way, but not the other. And we'll be seeing that again with our next two divisibility rules. This is a rule that typically kids are not going to learn in lower elementary. Typically, around 5th grade, students start to learn this. And when they move into middle school, this becomes an invaluable piece of knowledge to have in your mathematical toolbox, because there's so many activities that go on in middle school math and high school math, finding square roots, simplifying fractions, any number of things where if we had to divide out every single problem, it would take us forever to make some decisions. Whereas with these divisibility rules, we can very quickly look at a number and make a decision based on the divisibility rule. Now, here's a rule that many of you may already know, and for the benefit of those of you who do not, this turns out to be one of the most useful rules I know personally, because I use it all the time, both as a math teacher and as just a regular person. And the rule is pretty straightforward. It says if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, the number is divisible by 3. So let me say that again. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So let's take a look at our first example there, 141. In looking at that number, it's probably not immediately obvious to you that it is divisible by 3, but if you know this rule now of adding up the digits, so 1 plus 4 plus 1, hey, that's 6, and 6 is divisible by 3, which means the original number, 141, is also divisible by 3. Similarly now, for the second example, we're going to add up the digits and make our decision, so 4 plus 7 plus 5, well, 4 plus 7 is 11, plus 5 is, whoops, that's 16. I don't think any of them, even the ones that work here, are immediately obvious until you know this rule. So with the first example, 2803, add them up, you get 13, which is not divisible by 3, so that's the original number is not. How about 1005? Yes or no for 1005? Tell me in the chat box, please. Oh, I'm sorry to hear live video was interrupted. I hope you didn't miss much. Okay, indeed, 105 is divisible by 3 because 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 6, and 6 is divisible by 3, so we're in there. How about 435? Well, add it up. 4 plus 3 is 7, plus 5 is 12. Always be careful when doing your addition because that could be the source of some problems. So we add that up and we get 12, and 12 is divisible by 3, so 435 is as well. And the last number there, 199, well, let's see, 1 plus 9 is 10, 10 plus 9 is 19. Close, but not divisible by 3. So the rule for 3 again is a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Now, 3 shares that rule with the number 9. Notice the only difference in the statement here is a number is divisible by 9 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9. So 3 and 9 share the same rule. No other numbers have this add-up property except for 3 and 9. So let's check it out for the examples here. 792 added up. 7 plus 9 is 16, plus 2 is 18. Hey, that's divisible by 9, so 792 is divisible by 9. As I said, this is a pretty straightforward process once you understand the rules. And similarly, let's see, 825 added up. See, 8 and 2 is 10, and 5 is 15. So 825 is not divisible by 9. By the way, notice that it is divisible by 3. So just as some numbers can be divided by 5 but not by 10, similarly here, some numbers can be divided by 3 but not by 9. So be careful when applying these rules because they're very specific. And understanding them and not getting the rules confused or mixed up is the key to dealing with divisibility rules. Okay, let's take a look now. We have some interesting exercises here. The first question here in divisibility practice is the number 5,280, is that divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, and 10? So I'm going to give you a second to respond in the chat box. Turns out that it is divisible by all of those numbers except for 1. So you might want to just point out in the chat box which is the 1 that's missing there. Okay, chat box is not quite caught up to the questions. Again, the question is which one of these numbers here is 5280 not divisible by? Kind of change the question from what it says. Okay. Well, let's see. Definitely divisible by 2 because it ends with an even digit. Divisible by 3 because it adds up to 15, which is divisible by 3. 4 goes into the last 2 digits, so it's divisible by 4. Ends with a 0, so it's divisible by 5. 8. Okay, it's not immediately obvious that 8 goes into 280 without doing some actual long division. So let's use the half of a half of a half method here. Half of 280 is 140. We did this one a little earlier. Half of 280 is 140. Half of 140 is 70. And half of 70 is 35. So 8 goes in. How about 9? Well, let's see. 9 and 3 have that same rule, so the digits still add up to 15, which is not divisible by 9. So 9 is the one number so far that does not go into 5280. And finally, 10, yes, it definitely does because it ends with a 0. So all of our divisibility rules apply to this number except for 9. Okay, now I have an interesting little critical thinking challenge for you here. Find the missing number. Number. You misused the word that I said we had to get correct. What is the missing digit? So this number, 35 blank, can be divided by 9. And there's a sub-question there. Is there more than one answer to this question? So let's take a moment and think about it. Is what digit would I have to put in after 35 to make a number that ends in 9? Okay, I'm already seeing answers to this. One is that one there and no more. One, there's only one answer, and that is absolutely correct. Because 3 plus 5 is 8, so we need to make a multiple of 9, so adding a 1 there works perfectly. And no other digit is going to give us a number that adds up to a multiple of 9. So the answer to this question, One is the missing digit, and there is one and only one answer here. Okay, next question, similar but different. Fill in the missing digit so that the number cannot be divided by 9. So, I see a 7 there. That works very well. What we need to do is make sure that when we add it up, it does not add up to a multiple of 9. So 7 works beautifully there. 2 plus 7 is 9, plus 8 is 17. Okay. Any other choices? Somebody says 1, correct, because 2 plus 1 is 3, plus 8 is 11. In fact, all the digits work except for what digit? There's one digit which will work in this and no other. And somebody proposed, okay, the 9 is a missing digit, correct? What one digit would make this true? 2 blank 8. And I'm seeing lots of good answers for the real question there. That extra question I'm asking here, what digit would actually make it divisible by 9? Any thoughts? Well, if we put an 8 there, 2 plus 8 is 10, plus 8 is 18. So that would give us a number that cannot be divided by, that would give us a number that can be divided by 9. So all the other digits except 8 will satisfy this question. So there definitely is more than one answer here. Okay, let's move on to practice number 2 with a similar kind of thing here. Find the missing digit here so that the number can be divided by 4. And I'll hold on and let people have a chance to get their answers in the chat box. Okay, there are actually, 2 answers to this question that work. So what's that missing digit? 320 what is divisible by 4? Not sure that somebody replied 3. I'm not sure that they're answering this question because that would not work here, because 23 is not divisible by 4. So, okay, Maria, you said 323. Unfortunately, that's not... This one asks, so it can be divided by 4. The two answers that you gave, Maria, were answers that cannot. Because for it to be divisible by 4, recall that the last two digits need to be divisible by 4. Actually, there are 3 answers to this. We put a 0 there, 320, 20 is divisible by 4, 24 is divisible by 4, and 28 are divisible by 4. So there are actually 3 answers to this question. And finally, we have one more to go here. Fill in the missing digit so this number cannot be divided by 3. 1,300 something or other. So what is it? So what couple of digits will work here to make this number not divisible by 3? By the way, if you can handle these questions, you're doing really well with the divisibility rules, because a little bit of critical thinking here takes those rules and puts them into a little bit broader context. So what am I saying here? 1,300 works beautifully. Put 2 zeros there, and you got 1 plus 3 plus 0 plus 0 is 4, not divisible by 3, so that's a great answer to this question. Anyone else? Nice job, Maria. That was nice. Let's see, 345, someone says. Yep, because 1 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 is 13, and that's not going to give us a number divisible by 3. I think you guys got the idea now. Put 2 11s there. And as long as we don't get a number that adds up to 3, a multiple of 3, we're in business here. And finally, a direct challenge here, and don't make the number too easy. Create a 4-digit number that's divisible by 8, and pop that guy into the chat box. Appears to be about a 15-second delay in here. Sorry about that, guys, but I do want to see how you're responding. 3,800, good. little cheap, but a good answer. The last 3 digits are definitely divisible by 8. How about something a little bit more involved? $8,000? 8,000 definitely works. 2,400? A bit more challenging one for someone to determine whether you're right or not. 4,000? Good answer. Oh, I like it. 7,200, 3,400. You know, all these answers, by the way, don't have to end with two zeros. Many of the examples that I've given you don't end in two zeros, because what we need is, again, a number that you can split in half 3 times to be the last 3 digits, and that'll carry the day here. And see, just lots of, there we go, a 1320. Nice answer, good. Alrighty, let me go back to full screen now. Well, today's presentation has been divisibility rules basic. The next presentation will be divisibility rules advanced, where we're going to carry on with the rest of the numbers that students typically learn at school, and then some of the numbers that students typically do not. And in fact, there's a very general strategy for.
I think one of the best things about at home is that it really feels like you're almost at home with the student in their house teaching them.
I'm in my comfort zone.
You can just ask for help and the instructor will come right to you.
With Mathnasium at home, I know that they're getting the help that they need.
Awesome, great job.
Mathnasium, changing lives through math.